has overcome the lies, the good news of His Majesty in His Christ. And it is vital that we raise our tribal flag, the flag of the conquering lion of the tribe of Yehuda.
See also Abere. Let's go to Abere for a moment. Let's touch on Abere for a moment. And this is very important for our studies, and I think this needs to go out next. I asked the Father, I said, what do we need to teach on? And He showed me that this is what needs to be taught on. Because most of us are trying to grasp this, you know, trying to grasp this on the solo tip. You understand? Thinking that we are Solomon. We're not Solomon. You understand? There was one Solomon, and the greater than Solomon is here. So we're not Solomon. You understand? So we need to understand the Haver teaching. You understand? Which leads to Haverut, friendship, membership in a Havura. A Havura, a Havura, a Havura, it means society. It's very interesting. When we talk about Lion of Judah society and paying your debt to society, we're saying the Lion of Judah Mahiber or Mahiber. You understand? The Lion of Judah Mahiber, you understand? Or Mahber, you understand? Which means the Lion of Judah society. That word also in the Orit, Haile Selassie's Torah, or the Orit of the Negush Negesh, King of Kings, that word right there also means the congregation. You understand? When we're dealing with the sanctuary language and tabernacle language, that speaks of the congregation. So as the congregation or the society, that holy society, you understand, that line of Jewish society, the word is Machiber. You understand? Machiber. You understand? But then in the Hebrew we have Haver. Haver or Haber. Haver or Haver. Haber. You understand? Basically it's the same word. I want to show you how important this word is to modern day Judaism, to the modern day Jews. You understand? And this is why they're able to run circles around us with our stolen legacy. Even though we say we're Hebrews, we're the real Jews, the black man, the real Jews, so forth and so on, and they stole our legacy. All we're doing is basically is running up our blood pressure. You understand? Because see, my preaching and teaching on this made me feel good. Because it's the truth. You understand? And it shows us, you understand, a way out of this chaos. You understand? A way out of this confusion. It shows us a way out of Babylon. It shows us how to exit this, how to come out of Babylon. You understand? The most maybe stressing part of it is reaching out to you all. You understand? Reaching out to you all, you all who are know-it-all. You understand? Especially y'all out there that try to contradict the truth and don't even know you're Fidel. You understand? So what you need to do, you understand? You need to study and to show yourself approved. You understand? You know that verse, right? Study and show yourself approved to God as a workman that need not be ashamed. Now that's New Testament, right? That's New Testament. But that was Paul's, Saul's, the Hebrew, the Benjamite name, Paul's testimony or epistle to Timothy. Timothy's mother, if I'm correct, she was a Hebrew woman, and her father was, I mean, his father was a Gentile. So he was like a half tribe, like Manasseh and Ephraim, so to speak. You understand? But where was Paul coming from when he said to study and show yourself approved? He's coming from the Havruta. The Havruta. What is the Havruta? The Havruta, it means the study of Torah or Talmud. Now people run down to Talmud, but don't get it twisted. Talmud, what does Talmud mean? See, a lot of y'all talk about the connotative meaning of Talmud. Oh, Talmud is what the Jews say is racist and, you know, it's their teachings. No, Talmud basically means teachings. You understand? But the Talmud of the so-called Jews is not the Talmud of the King of Kings. Understand that. The teachings of His Imperial Majesty is what we mean when we talk about the Talmud of the King of Kings. So that word Havruta, it means in Hebrew, Havruta or Havruta, it means the study of Torah or Talmud in pairs. In pairs. In pairs. You understand? In pairs. Like when we talk about I and I, usually you see one boy talk about I and I. And then you look and you say, well, where's the other I? Where's the other I? You know what I'm saying? Christ sent out the disciples and the apostles two by two. You understand? Police go out there on the roll and patrol two by two. You understand? Any gang that's worth the G in the name go out at least two by two. You understand? When we talk about brethren, two by two. You understand what I'm trying to say right here? So the Havruta is important because we need to start to study the Ethiopic Orit and the teachings of His Imperial Majesty in pairs. And it's considered an integral part of the traditional Jewish study. This is the integral part of the Lion of Judah study. Is studying in pairs. And I don't mean you and your woman studying. Cause, I mean, you know, you should study with your woman, your sister, and so forth and so on. I'm not saying don't. What I'm saying is, as a brethren, you're saying you need to learn to study the Ethiopic Torah. We're speaking about the Metav Kedus of the King of Kings. You understand? And the teachings of His Imperial Majesty in pairs. We need to pair up. We need to pair up, brethren. Some brethren say, well, they want to have enough mind and bring enough mind to the same truth. Bring yourself and your brethren, and let's begin to study. Let's begin right there. You understand? Because if we can't deal with that one thing, you understand? How can we deal with many things? You understand what I'm saying? So it's considered an integral part of the traditional Yehuda study. Often a Havruta studies in the Beit Midrash. The Beit Midrash, you understand, is the house of study or a study hall. It's like when we say the Timheret Beit. When we speak about the Timheret Beit or we speak about the Tamari Beit, it means to study together with other Havrutot. Okay, so right here, from this particular messianic study, you understand, Hebrew study, you see these two Ashkenazi or Hasidic, Hasidim, Havruta, you see them studying in pairs right there. You understand? Why don't we see brethren studying like that? How come I not Rastafari brethren not studying like that? You understand? Because that wasn't passed on to us. You see, study wasn't passed on. Everybody talk about bingi. You understand? Chanting song, puffing weed. You understand? And saying Selassie. But what about the study? You understand? Study and show ourselves approved. This is why there is the backwardness. You understand? We don't want to talk about it. Nobody, no country want to talk about backwardness. Even in the time of His Imperial Majesty, Ethiopia didn't want to deal with those areas of her own backwardness. But the King of Kings had to confront that. You understand? Just like I and I right now, Rasi Adinos and the Lineage Society of His Imperial Majesty have to confront that. It's backward. You understand? It's backwardness. Everybody's running around chasing papers. So y'all got the monies? You understand? So y'all need to give something for this teaching. You understand? People say, well, the knowledge should be free. Really? That's why you want to send your children to school, right? And you pay for the education. Knowledge should be free. Food should be free too. How come you don't hear people say food should be free? How come you hear people say that housing should be free? You understand? How come you don't hear people say that gas and cars and clothing and music and everything else should be free? Because I just thought about it. I said, wait. The King of Kings has given I and I the knowledge and the will to teach this. And y'all have the need to learn this. But when we talk about, you understand, you giving your part, just like in the tabernacle or the tent, everyone had to give a portion of a shekel. You understand? Had to give a portion of a shekel. You couldn't come, you understand, to God empty. You understand? You had to give something towards that. So enough ones want to, you know, chat about this.